Hello everyone, welcome back. In this video, I'm going to talk about the updates which happen during the weekends. There are two main updates to talk about. The first one is the official implementation of Flux Control Net inside of ComfyUI. And the second one is we have some more LoRAs to play with. And then at the end of the video, I'm going to talk about a few things which are left out in previous videos. All right, so here's the ComfyUI pose for the XLab Flux ControlNet implementation. And last time I also showed this pose. Basically, there were a lot of issues when trying to use the ControlNet, but now it has been fixed. And this branch has also been merged to the master branch. So now it is officially in the main master branch. Now, it is very important to update your ComfyUI to the latest version. If you have the ComfyUI portable version, go inside the update folder and then just double click on the update underscore ComfyUI.bat. If you've manually installed ComfyUI, then you will have this ComfyUI folder. Open a terminal and navigate to this folder and then do git pull to get the latest changes. Now, start your ComfyUI and in this pose, the first image that you will see at the very top is actually the workflow. So you can take this image, drag it inside of ComfyUI to get the workflow. So it will look something like this. The only thing that will be different is that this model will say Flux Dev FP8. Now I've changed it to the Schnell version just so that it's faster. But you can leave it as the dev one. Now make sure you're downloading the ControlNet model as well. So again, on this post here, if you go down, there will be a link where you can go and find the model. Click on the link, it will open Hugging Face. And if you've used Hugging Face a couple of times, you know that you need to click on this little download icon here to download the model. Now the file name says controlnet.safetensors. Once it's downloaded, cut it or move it to the ComfyUI models, ControlNet, and then paste it here. Now, for me, I've renamed mine as ControlNet underscore Canny underscore Flux underscore XLab. It's the same name that we have in the workflow. You can do the change or you can click on refresh once you've moved the file to the correct folder and then just select it from here. Now, if you're using the dev model, then after your conditioning here, you will need to add, I believe it's called flux, yes, flux guidance. And then you will need to play with the flux guidance. And this is just a canny edge detection method. So if you've used any canny model for ControlNet in SD 1.5 or SDXL, it's the exact same thing. You're going to have your load image. In this particular case, it is basically rescaling it to 512 by 512. Then we have this preview here. It goes through the apply control net, which is the advanced version. We have the positive and negative. And the strength is very important here. If you go too high, you will get some lines in your image. And of course, if you're too low, it's not going to follow the input image exactly. Now in the post here, if you scroll down, there are a few people who did some testing and they posted their findings in here. So this is a good post to bookmark if you want to keep on testing this model. You can also contribute as well. So here's just one post here telling you what's supported and what's not. And then you can see a few notes here. Now, of course, depending on the model that you're using here, you will either go 20, 25 steps or the 4 steps for the Schnell. Also know that the empty latent image is at 512 by 512, and that's why the control net image was also rescaled to 512 by 512. And this is the result, so you can see it's following the canny edge closely. Now, of course, going too high actually messes up the image, and going too low basically ignore the input image. So play around with the settings and go through this post. There are a few errors that people got, and there are a few solutions to those errors as well. You will also see a couple of example reference image. Okay, so next let's talk about the XLab Flux LoRaWAS. This is the main page, so if you'd like to test the standalone version, this is how you can do it. Now if you scroll down, it tells you the different models that we have, and then we have a couple of examples here. Now going to Hugging Face page, into files and versions, we can see that we have quite a few that you can test out. Now, when you are testing it out for Comfy UI, make sure that you are using the LoRa, which says _comfy_converted inside of Comfy UI. Same thing, you need to download the files and then go inside your Comfy UI, look for the LoRaWAS folder and then paste them here. Okay, so this is an example without the LoRa. So I have the LoRa node here disabled, and we have the basic image from the default prompt. When enabling the LoRa and I have the strength at 1, the image barely changed. It's different. Not sure if it's like visible in the video, but it's not what I was expecting it to be. I was expecting the style to change to an anime, because this is the anime _LoRa. And I will show you some examples right after. Now, so I thought maybe it's the strength of the LoRa that needs to increase. So I tried going to 10, but 10 doesn't work. I've also tried 5. That also did not work. Even at 2, I did not get good result. So here's a few examples with the different LoRaWAS. And I tried to keep the prompt exactly the same. So this first one is using that Midjourney 6 LoRa. And then we have two examples. One has different styles in the prompt. The other one does not, but they are both using the same LoRa. This one is using the Realism LoRa. At strength 1, we have this. At strength 2, you can see that it's no longer an image. So clearly something is not working inside of Comfy UI, or I'm not using it correctly. And if you see these three images, they are practically the same, just a little bit of difference. This is the Realism. The face is slightly better. This is the Midjourney one, and this is the Disney one. Now, what I was expecting to happen is this. So this is what they show in the demo. Now, it's possible that I'm not using the correct trigger word. I've tried copying the same prompt, but I could not get these results here. But this is what we're expecting to get. And as you can see, the Disney, it looks like Disney, the anime is anime. Have the Midjourney, it's quite nice. And then we have furry. Go down, we have a scenery as well as an art LoRa. All right, so additionally, we have some other LoRaWAS by individuals, and I'm going to leave the link in the description below. This one is by David. As you can see, you can do illustration. I've tried it directly on Hugging Face page, and it does seem to work, but I'm not sure if we have a Comfy UI compatible one yet. I believe Comfy Anonymous has a Python script which can convert the XLab version to a Comfy UI compatible. So maybe we can give that one a try afterwards. But testing it directly from the Hugging Face page, you can see that it can do illustration, and it can also do these ones. So all the images I've tested, they are always this illustration type. Now, here's another one. This one is by Jimmy Carter. And you can see I'm using the same prompt here. This one, we have a different image. So clearly this is working. There's another one that gives you this type of style. And you can see the same prompt, but different style. And this one has a trigger word. So I've tried without the trigger word and with the trigger word, like so. Now for the XLab one, unfortunately, like I said, I could not get it to work inside of Comfy UI. Hopefully, maybe there's going to be updates, or if I'm doing something wrong, you'll tell me in the comments down below. Now, I would like to touch a little bit on the license, because there was a confusion about this in one of the videos comment section. There was discussion about it, saying that the dev model is non-commercial, which is true. The model itself and all of its derivative are under a non-commercial research purpose only. However, in one section of that license, it tells us here that outputs are not considered derivative under this license. And you can continue reading the entire license as well. But basically, if you're using the model, the dev model, you generate some images, you can use those images for commercial purposes. However, you cannot use the model, so you cannot host the model on a different website and then charge other people to use that model. Hopefully, I'm making this clear concerning the license. The Schnell version, that one is under commercial. You can use it for commercial purposes. That's fine. Oh, yes. If you are not able to update your Conf UI or it's just not working, you can try downloading the Conf UI Windows Portable. And this one should have the update already added to it. Now, lastly, I would like to talk about this video here, where I said Conf UI big update, a new front end coming soon. So that's going to be in about 2 days, depending on when you're watching this video. There's a new preview that was posted on Twitter. It's basically the new setting page. It's going to look different. Now, instead of the long scrolling clutter that we had before, this time we have this nice UI, different categories on the left. Then we have the different options, the toggle buttons that you can do from in the right side here. And you can see the version that they are using here. It's the version 1.2.13. So if you update your Conf UI and you go to this version, you can also test this new feature. And in case you're not aware, I would recommend you watching this video. I talk about the big updates, how it's going to change. And of course, it's not supposed to impact your image generation. It's only the front end that's changing. All right, so that is it for today's update. The ControlNet is good news. Was able to get it to work and it's great. But the LoRaS is just not working. I've seen a lot of people saying that the LoRaS for Flux is meant to have subtle changes. And then most of the image generation is influenced by the prompt. Now, for this particular test that I've done, I've kept the prompt the same. It's quite basic, but I wanted to check if the LoRa would influence the model to push towards new style. But based on the result I got, I'll say it's not looking great for the LoRas. But like I said, I may be wrong. It's possible that I've done something wrong. Let me know in the comments down below. And maybe we can have a follow-up video on the same topic. All right, so thank you for watching. Have a nice day ahead, and I will see you in the next one.